Hello everybody, thank you for attending my session here. Today I will talk about how to create a native GNOME app for Ubuntu, and eventually we will publish it to Ubuntu software through Snapcraft. Before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Kertito Duyaguno. My friend call me Pico, just Pico. I am a software engineer at Digital Advertising Company. We are using Ubuntu too. Ubuntu is everywhere, even in this MacBook. Actually, this is my wife's MacBook, and I installed Ubuntu without her permission. Also, belakang project contributor, and I was activist for few local communities like TPLNTB, Blibogor, and then Lombok Dev. The last one is more like programming community. Okay. Enough about me. I will divide this talk into four parts. The first one is about preparation, how to prepare all of these things, and then ideation, how to put your idea into the something that you can review over and over for reference while you are developing your app, and then development phase, you will doing the coding, and then the last one, to build and publish your app into snapcraft.io. Okay, preparation. First, you will need GNOME Builder. GNOME Builder is an IDE, Integrated Development Environment, like Android Studio, if you know. Except GNOME Builder is a lot more simpler than Android Studio. So if you have experience on Android Studio, you might not be satisfied with what GNOME Builder is, because it has less feature. But don't worry, because the simplicity of GNOME Builder will not hold you back from creating a beautiful native app in Linux environment. You can install GNOME Builder by using Ubuntu software directly using Apt. I recommend you to install to this Ubuntu repository, not Flattack, because the Flattack provides the newest version, which is not compatible with the other software that I will introduce later. And then, you will need UI designer to design the UI, the layout of your app. But we have small problem here. We have option. The first one is great. It support GTK 3, but no, doesn't support GTK 4. It is not actively maintained anymore. And then we have Tumblr. This is the shortest form of Glade. It supports GTK 4, but it is not stable and maybe have bug. And then maybe we have to wait for the next version of GNOME Builder, hoping that it will have integrated UI designer inside the GNOME Builder. And then the last option, to write the UI file manually by hand. So my recommendation is to be flexible on this. We will use Tumblr to design the basis layer, and when it happened that Tumblr cannot fulfill our need, we have to write the UI manually. But it is like HTML, so it is like HTML, so you don't have to fail. Not that difficult. So this is something like look like Glade, but less feature. And then we will need Flatpak. I know this talk is about Snap, but Flatpak is important here. If you open GNOME Builder, you will find this green button. If you click that, GNOME Builder will build your app and generate an egg and package, Flatpak package out of the box. It got me by surprise. So actually, GNOME Builder has very nice integration with Flatpak. By default, GNOME Builder will target your host system. But with Flatpak, it will allow you to target different systems. Let's say that you are in older system like GNOME 40 and then you want to target more modern system like GNOME 45 maybe, it is possible on 5%. And then, why Snap? I know, see, maybe all of you had Snap. Now watch Hati Snap too. But few of my friends were asking the same question. Are you serious? Why do you want to talk about Snap despite its weakness, security flaw, or proprietary code in the back end? I would not argue with them. Their arguments are technically correct. I respect them. But the thing is, if it happened that you have different goal, like me, like I want to reach as much user as possible, or I want a lot of people get benefit from my application, then Snap is what I should. So we are not talking about Snap versus Flatpak. It is about RDI, then equality, diversity, also competition. Let's think about this. My wife, I know my wife is not Ubuntu user, but let's say that she is Ubuntu user and she loves his her computer, and then the thing is she is not technology savvy like us. She doesn't know about Flatpak. She doesn't care about Snap. What she know if she need an app that is not available in her computer, what she did is to open Ubuntu software, tap the keyword, install the app, that's all. She doesn't know about terminal command line like blah 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 blah. So my beautiful wife is deserves to get the app, right? So equality matters here. So that is why I want to talk about Snap. I was happy Snap, but along the way when I preparing this talk, I become understand about why Snap is also important in this ecosystem. Okay, then we will name Snapcraft, not Snap. Snap is a package manager, but Snapcraft is a tool to build Snap package. Snapcraft has dependency on LXD, LXD container. There is some issue from my experience. By default, LXD container cannot connect to the internet, but it doesn't work what out of the box. So we have to apply some workaround like this to enable the firewall and disable the IPv6 and IPv4 firewall. At least some IP tables to do. And the last thing, you will need your favorite game element. The GNOME Builder support a lot of programming language, but my recommendation is to use the programming language that have good GTK binding library. There are C, Rust, JavaScript, Python. I'm not sure about the rest, but you might want to try first with .4. Okay, part 2, ideation. You have to define the problem first. I have my own problem. This is my problem. This device called StackMap. It works by putting your hand into the StackMap. It will be ready. When you raise your hand, it will be starting to count the time. Then you shove the cube. When you are done with this, you put your hand again to the StackMap, and the timer will stop, and you will have yourself in time. I didn't find any app that resemble this StackMap behavior, so I want to create one. And then you have to define the basic function and the filter to solve the problem. In my case, the first one is to measure the time, like StackMap with its behavior, and then to generate the array of notation to scramble it too before I play with this. And the last one is it should be able to lock the solving time. And then after you have a basic function, you have to put that function into some design or wireframe. This is important because it will be reference for your development process. Okay, so we are starting the development. This is GNOME Builder. It will ask you whether you want to open the existing project or the example project or start new project. When you start new project, it will ask you information like project name, then application ID, path, language. I will be using Python here, lesson, and then paste it in our application, not the latest one. About the application ID, this is important. You have to define your application ID based on previous step guidelines. If you have your own domain, maybe blog or website, you can use your domain here. Just refresh the domain, tlb, then your domain, then dot your app now. If you don't have domain, you can hosting your app into GitHub, then using github.io domain for your namespace application. And then maybe GNOME Builder will ask you to install SDK dependency. Just follow the instructions. I will explain the anatomy of GNOME Builder. The top bar, you will have button to control this pane and this pane. And this is to control the build. You can build, rebuild, clean, select different target system. And this to run the app. So you can have preview, live preview of your app. This is the menu. And this is the side pane where you can explore your source tree, your code. This is the editor. If you are familiar with NGA, the terminal. We have logger and search feature. Okay, I will explain the most important thing in the source tree. This tree file, main.py, and then window.py. This is where you will write your logic and connect the logic into command. This is where you will write the UI. Manually using internal applet blend or Kembley. I will show you how to work with Kembley. Just right click, then click external program, select Kembley, and you will got this. This is the default template for the builder. Okay, this is my app. Actually, it has been published to Snap and Flathub, but I will not demonstrate how to build this app from start because we don't have enough time. Instead, I will show you how to connect the dot between the UI and your function in your code. I hope it will give you big picture how to work on this. If you think my talk is not sufficient for your learning process, don't worry because I have prepared blog post series in detailed manner, so you will not miss anything here. If you think you have questions, then please contact me. Please ask me directly. I have Telegram and email. Okay, I will demonstrate how to work with GNOME Builder and Kembley. We create new project, maybe etz dot test. Sorry. Python. Terus then I will open this template. I will remove this label, add a button, then when we click this button, it will change the label of the cell. So we will have a function and event handler of the click event. Okay, I will remove this. The search for button component. Add the component to this parent, then add a label. Oh, I don't see the label here. But this is enough. I will save. Then, save is not enough. You have to export the file. Then we will go back to the video. Okay, this is the basic layer that the template has helped me to create. We have button. I will add level to it. So then I will identifier. This is important. So each component that you want to work with should have identifier. Let's say two. Okay. And then we must to the pattern code. I will call the component. Then create a basic function like to changing the label. Then okay, this init will be executed on the starting time. So I want to connect the event to the function on the scope.
Okay. Kita export ke dia. Ini export.
Ini just good. I need some time to look at the friend. This one. Identifier, then the label. I call the label here, the button. With identifier, then I connect the component to function and set the function to change the label. The main challenge in developing GNOME apps is the reference, because the documentation is based on the C language. So, other language basically is just abstraction of this C building. Okay, shall we continue to If you want to learn from my shortcut, please visit my repository. When I said not easy, it is about the preparing the LX container. And to be patient to work for the pandemic to be done. We have 5 steps here to publish our app, register the, prepare the instrument, build process, upload, and then upload. These 2 is the most hardest part. Actually, you can register your app through command line interface, but I recommend you to register the app through the website, because the website has interface to upload things like icons, screenshot. So it is all in one solution to Vista compared to the command line. And then before you build your app, you have to define the SnapCraft manifest file. You have to put the snap directory, then write the snapcraft manifest file here. This manifest file have 5 important parts. The first one is about the metadata, your app name, version, then summary, description, the grade, whether you want to release your app in stable or beta, then the app. It is about how to run your app. Where is the executable binary? Then slot, it is about where you want to connect your app. In my case, my app need connection to the bus service. Then layout, if your executable binary have dependent on other file, like maybe UI file, CSS, then you have to define the path here. The last one, the path. Path is about how to build your app. What is the build system? I am using the mission here. The mission parameter, the app data file, build dependence, and runtime dependence. If you want to run some script or custom tweak, you can do this here. So build time, You can build your snap by running snap graph then enter as simple as that. But my recommendation is to split your thumbnail into two pane then you have actually monitor so you will know if your snap build process really spawning and running still actually container. And then snap graph. You need to add that velocity test. So if something goes wrong, you will know immediately. This is the build process. If you see this content, then the ticket is ready to upload. Okay. Then upload process. As simple as snapchat upload, then your kanal stable data, then the package file. At this point, actually your snapchat is uploaded to snapchat.io. If there is no permission issue, it will be published immediately in the snapchat.io and Ubuntu software. But if you have need special permission, in my case, it is the bus service connection. It need permission from the snapchat team. You have to ask them directly to approve your permission. But this is a very quick process. Less than 24 hours, my application gets approved. This is when I request for the permission. And essentially, it's the approved. And finally, my app get published in the Ubuntu software. Okay, again, I am in no mean to start a work, right? But I want to tell you my experience so you have reference and clue. On working on snap build time. Flutter is very quick, feasible, and I'm very happy with Flutter on the build time because it is already integrated in the GNOME builder, right? Simply export bundle then. But snap, I spend days to make this build successful. But the publish time, Snap is the winner. Snap has no quality control. You enter the upload, but it doesn't care if your app has no icon or crashing on the user, it doesn't care. No quality control. But Flathub, the reviewer of Flathub team, it's really strict about quality control. If you have missing icon, they will remind you to add the icon. And from my experience, it takes 3 days to get published to GitHub. Okay, I want to show off my app. I believe I have installed. See, this is installed for Snap, that's my icon. And until this day, I don't know how to set the icon. So, this is my app. Like, I follow this notation to scrambling tool. Then I put my hand to the spacebar. It will be ready, and then when I raise my hand, when I am done with this, yep. Just like that, very simple. Okay, break this.
Yes.
Okay, for this follow up, I have prepared you the blog post so you can read. Better. This one, and I also have planned to create a video tutorial, and I will let you know maybe later from by within Terganja channel. So that is all. Thank you. Any question?
Thank you, sir. I want to ask about Snap, but it looks like have I have documents or relation, have a relation between Google. For now, in Ubuntu version 23.10, Ubuntu Server is here with Flutter. Banyak ini terutama pak harus pakai Flutter juga si GNOME softwarenya itu. Kenapa kalau nggak stay di kasih sebelumnya buat si ini apa sih tujuannya buat si aplikasinya GNOME ini ada Ubuntu softwarenya itu kenapa pakai Flutter dan pakai yang CDK-nya tadi itu?
Bukan?
Pertanyaannya tuh agak dekat sama Snap gitu sih. Jadi itu kalau di tadi juga di atas itu nanti kan si Ubuntu softwarenya kan pakai itu udah pakai Flutter itu biasanya itu kenapa nggak di stay di ini nggak di stay di yang kan sebelumnya aja biasanya itu Ubuntu software tapi ini kita harus ke Snap itu kenapa harus pindah jadinya kan nggak pakai CDK lagi secara umum gitu itu dapat Flutter kira-kira alasannya kenapa ya? Tanya kan setahu aku Flutter itu apa sih butuhnya
by using native component of the K. This is native component, native style from GNOME. That I have another app. Style from GNOME. This button in the top bar is also native style of GNOME. So we are talking about native. Flutter doesn't provide native style like this. So about the why I recommend you to using the latest GNOME version because it might provide you the latest feature of GTK component. Okay, thank you for the question. Anyone?
Thank you, Mr. Rico, for the explanation. One question. Sometimes we build application with lot of dependency, and sometimes the dependency is post update, and our application is crash and we can't update it anymore. How can we maintain our application to use? How can we update a legacy app? Aplikasi sudah lama kita bangun sudah lama itu, tapi tetap bisa menggunakan library-nya itu. Jadi ketika library salah satu library-nya itu update, aplikasi kita tidak bisa dijalankan itu. How can we maintain their dependency?
Okay, I think this is what Snap and Flutter try to solve. When we have a conventional Linux repository like Debian repository, it is very hard to get the legacy app, the app or dependency or library into this repository. But with Flutter, it is very easy to publish all legacy library. So you have to learn how to bridge Flatpak or Snap package. So mainly Flatpak, and then when you have depending on the your legacy library, you can use Flatpak to get that. So maybe not as simple as snap your app name. Maybe you will need Flatpak to support your snap app.
One more question. Is there any alternative Genome Builder? Alternative Genome Builder alternative? And one question again. Is there how can we make easy report?
Unfortunately, no.
Can we but in my in
yeah, just Genome Builder. But in my preference, I like to use Qt. How to pronounce this?
Qt.
Because it's more a lot of feature and very actively developed. But it is more difficult to use from my experience. And I know maybe after you see this talk, you feel that Genome Builder is very silly, too simple, less feature, and like it is not very intuitive to build the layer, right? You have to, yeah, been see that. So, unfortunately, we don't have many options here, just Genome Builder. Maybe if you don't like Genome Builder, just use Vim and tag. Yeah. Actually, we have two ways to build Genome app by using Genome Builder and template, or not using UI file at all. So actually, we can invoke component programmatically from our code without using UI XML file. Okay, I think thank you for attending my session.